Hi makers, welcome back to You Make Tech. In today's episode, we will be programming a robot with Python. I printed this robotic arm from Thingiverse. I added the link in the description. The robot is controlled by four servo motors, three to control the axis and one to open and close the hand. There is a fifth servo on the ramp to open and close the gate to release the ball. The robot is connected to the computer using an Arduino Uno board. The Arduino Uno is powered by USB or by a 5V power supply. It has 6 analog inputs which can be used to read sensors and 14 digital input outputs, of which 6 can be used to control servo motors using PWM. Arduino uses its own programming language, which is very similar to C++. The normal way to program an Arduino is to write a program on your computer, compile it and upload it to the Arduino. This is not very convenient and interactive. This is why in today's episode we will be flashing the Arduino with a special program called StandardFirmata. Firmata allows to control all Arduino pins from the PC by communicating with the Arduino over USB. This makes possible to control the Arduino remotely, from the Python shell or from a Python script. Okay, let's flash the Arduino with Firmata Standard. I connect the Arduino board to the computer and open the Arduino IDE. The standard FirmataStandard program is available in the examples that come with the Arduino IDE. I upload it by clicking on the arrow. If everything works as expected, FirmataStandard should be now running on the Arduino. That's all we need to do on the Arduino side. Let's connect the servo motors to the Arduino Uno. Each servo has 3 wires. The brown is the ground, the red is the power, and the orange is the signal. I connect the brown wire to the ground, and the red wire to the plus 5V of the Arduino board. The orange wire shall be connected to one of the 6 Arduino digital PWM outputs, D3, D5, D6, D9, D10 or D11. Now we can connect the Arduino to the PC via USB. We are now almost ready to move our servo motor with Python. But before that, we must install the Python module pyFirmata using pip install. Once this is done, I open the Python interpreter, import the pyFirmata module, and establish a connection with the Arduino over USB. The port to use is displayed in the Arduino IDE. I specify that pin 9 should be used to control a servo. Get pin requires 3 parameters separated by double points. D stands for digital, 9 is a pin number, and S means that pin should be used to control a servo. To move the servo, I call the function right with an angle between 0 and 180 degrees. Now that we successfully moved one servo, we are now ready to connect the 5 servo of our robot to the Arduino Uno. As the Arduino Uno has not enough pins to connect the 5 servos, I use the breadboard to distribute the Arduino plus 5V to the 5 servo red wires and the Arduino ground to the 5 servo ground wires. I connect the orange wires directly to the Arduino digital PWM pins D3, D5, D6, D9 and D10. That's it! We are now ready to control our robot with Python. The code is almost identical to the code shown earlier to move one servo. But there is one issue. The robot moves too fast and has a tendency to oscillate. We have to move slower. Therefore, we implement a for loop and increment the angle 1 degree by 1 degree with a small pause between each move. I pause for 15 milliseconds. Of course, I can control the robot like that, but this is too cumbersome to use. I would like to control the robot with intelligible orders like go to, open hand, close hand, and so on. Therefore, I create a class named RobotArm, which provides a high-level interface to the user and hides the details of the implementation. The entire code I use for this project is available on GitHub, and I put a link in the description. The class constructor init establishes the communication with the Arduino, configures the servo motors, and moves them to their initial positions, such that the robot always starts from the same configuration. There are four methods, set0, set1, set2, and set3, one for each servo of the robot, which are in charge to move slowly the four servo motors from their current positions to their desired positions. As before, they move the servo 1 degree at a time and wait 15 milliseconds before moving again. There is also a go-to method which takes as inputs 3 angles for the 3 robot axes. It allows to move the robot over 3 axes with one single command. Finally, we have 2 methods to open and close the hand and 2 methods to open and close the gates, such as to release the ball. Now that we have defined the class RobotArm, we can use it to move the robot or perform higher level tasks. I first import the module RobotArm. I create a robot object. As expected when creating the object, the class constructor init is automatically called by Python. Then I can call method of the robot to perform some actions. Alright, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did making it. Please let me know in the comments below. Do not forget to subscribe if you want to know when I release a new video. Thanks for watching and see you soon on New Mech Tech.